robinreaction.com.
In this video, I'll be going over limiting reagent practice problems. So if you feel like you don't know exactly what the concept of limiting reagent is, I have a video that just introduces that, so watch that first. This video is for when you feel comfortable diving into some practice problems. And so for all of these practice problems, we're going to follow the directions in blue. We're going to, one, make sure your equation is balanced. Can't tell you how many times I've seen someone do an entire problem and they get it wrong, they don't understand why, and it's because they didn't balance in step one. Don't assume that your equations are going to be balanced. Two, you want to get the number of moles of all the reactants that you have. And then three, you want to compare the ratios in your balanced equation with the ratios of actual moles that you have. And after you have that, you can determine your limiting reagent. All right, so we're going to start with some examples that go a little bit faster, and then our third example is going to be a little bit more involved. All right, so number one, what is your limiting and excess reagent if you have 2 moles of zinc and 2 moles of hydrochloric acid? So step one, we have to make sure that we're balanced. So I'm going to go ahead and put a 2 here. Now on each side, I have 1 zinc, I have 2 hydrogens, and I have 2 chlorines. So this is completely balanced. Everything else is a 1. All right, so number 2, get the number of moles of all reactants. And number 1, we've just been told. It says we have 2 moles of zinc and 2 moles of HCl. So now we have to compare the ratios in your balanced equation with the ratios of actual moles you have. And there are a few different ways that you can make this mole comparison. It's just ratios. You can set it up in various ways. I'm going to do a couple of ways, but whatever way works for you, whatever way your teacher showed you, as long as you feel like you understand it, that's completely fine. So the way I like to do these is to look at one reagent and think, how much do we have? Then look at the mole ratio of the other reagent and say, okay, how much of the other reagent would we need to have to use up all of our initial reagent? So what that means is we know that we have 2 moles of zinc. Let's do zinc first. And so the ratio I set up looks like this. On one side, it's the ratio of the balanced equation, and on the other side, it's going to be the ratio that we actually have. All right, so in the balanced equation, the actual coefficients we have is 1 for zinc and 2 for HCl. That's the left-hand side. And the right-hand side is how much zinc we actually have, and then we're going to calculate how much HCl we would need to use up all of that zinc. So now this is just solving. We solve for the question mark, and we get 4 moles HCl. So to use up the 2 moles of zinc we have, we would need twice that amount. We'd need 4 moles of HCl. And we know from the problem, we were actually only given 2 moles of HCl. So we do not have enough HCl to use all of the zinc. So this means that HCl is our limiting reagent. And that zinc is our excess reagent. So that's one way you can do it. You can calculate how much theoretical moles of something else you would need. Another way is to look at the balanced equation mole ratio and then look at the actual mole ratio that you have with your moles. So to do that, with our balanced equation, the actual mole ratio from zinc to HCl is 1 over 2 or 0.5. And then we can do what we actually have. And our actual ratio of how many moles of each we have is just 1. So we can see that our actual ratio is greater. And so that means that we had more zinc than we needed. And so you can kind of think the goal, the perfect scenario, would be that we had gotten 0.5 as our actual mole ratio. This would mean that we had equal amounts to use it up and we'd have no limiting reagent. But we got a number 1 that's larger than what we actually want. So we only need a mole ratio of 0.5 and we had a mole ratio of 1. So now if you just think about it as a fraction and you think, okay, if I want to go from 0.5 to 1, do I have to increase the numerator or the denominator? It means that you'd have to increase the numerator, right? That's the only way to get the number to be bigger. If we increase the denominator, our number would get smaller. So this means to go from 0.5 to 1, we'd have to increase the numerator, which means that we have more zinc than we need, which means we have excess of zinc. All right, so however you do this step, there's a bunch of different ways, and this is kind of the tricky part. So if you don't understand, look at your notes, watch this again, look up other ways, but however you get to it, you're going to have to understand this concept of ratios and getting to the point where you understand which one is excess and which one is limiting. So now let's do number two. What is your limiting and excess reagent if you have 0.746 moles of iron and 0.899 moles of water? So now I'm doing a problem that's still just moles. We aren't going from grams to moles yet, but it has more scraggly numbers and it's a little bit more complicated of balancing. So again, that's our first step always. Make sure your equation is balanced. So in this situation, I'm gonna go ahead. I need 3 irons, I need 4 oxygens. That means I'm gonna have to have 4 hydrogens also. So now checking through, this is balanced, and now I'm ready to just get the number of moles of all the reactants. So I have 0.746 moles of iron and 0.899 moles of water. All right, so now I'm back to my ratio, and I have to figure out which one am I going to run out of first. And so once again, let's start with my first version where we look at the balanced equation and set up a ratio that also lets us predict how much we would need of our other reagent. All right, so in our balanced equation, we have 3 moles of iron, and that is ratioed with 4 moles of H2O. So that's my first left-hand side of the fraction. And then that's going to equal, I'm starting with iron, 0.746 moles. That's how much we actually have. And now let's calculate, in an ideal world, how much water would we need. So just solving for the question mark with algebra. So to completely use up all of my 0.746 moles of iron, I would need 0.995 moles of H2O. So now I look at how much I actually have. I actually have 0.899 moles of water, and that is not enough. So that means that water is my limiting reagent, so iron is my excess. And let's do that in one more way of comparing the mole ratio. So let's do it where we use our balanced equation, and then we just get a pure number, and then we think about what our actual ratio is, and we compare those two numbers. All right, so our actual mole ratio in our balanced equation is 0.75. And now let's see what our mole ratio would be with the amount of moles of both those things that we actually have. All right, so we actually have a ratio of 0.829. And again, we can just ask ourselves some fraction math. So if we were trying to go from 0.75 to 0.829, would we increase the numerator or the denominator? And we would increase the numerator. That's how we get our fraction to be bigger. And so that means that we have too much iron. We have jammed in more iron than we need. Our mole ratio does not get us 0.75. It gets us something higher than that. And so that means that there's more iron. So I hope one of these ratio ways makes sense to you. I get this is the hardest part for most people. So if it's still confusing, it's okay. Just keep on drilling it in and trying it on your practice problems. Now let's do an example that your class will probably do. And this is where we're doing the same exact thing, except we don't start with already having the moles. We start with just being told masses, and we're going to have to go ahead and figure out the moles before we can get the answer. So the steps are the same. One, make sure your equation is balanced. So looking at this, I'm going to go ahead, add a 2 here, add a 3 here, and that is completely balanced. And so now I have to get the number of moles of all reactants. But now that's a little bit more difficult than it used to be. I used to just write it down. Now I know I actually just have 12.5 grams of nitrogen and 1.372 grams of hydrogen. And so we cannot go ahead and compare the ratios because remember, these are all about mole ratios. When you're balancing an equation, you're balancing the number of moles. you're not balancing the mass. That's completely different because different elements have wildly different masses. So before we can do any ratios with these two masses, we have to go ahead and turn them into moles, and that means that we need to use the molar mass. So the molar mass of both of these compounds, so the two molar masses are 28.02 grams per mole for nitrogen and 2.016 grams per mole for hydrogen. So now let's go ahead and divide and find the number of moles of each one of these. And now we're finally at number two. We have the number of moles of all your reactants. And now we can go ahead and compare the ratios in your balanced equation with the ratio of actual moles that you have. So one more time, I'm going to do both my ways, starting this time with making the actual ratio of the balanced equation and then comparing that to the ratio of what we actually have. All right, so once again in this situation, our actual mole ratio is 0.33. That's the amount where each one would just be used up completely and neither would be limiting or excess. And the actual ratio we have is 0.655. So once again, it's too high. And that means that our numerator has had extra stuff added to it, which means we have an excess in the numerator, which means that N2 is your excess reagent and that H2 is your limiting reagent. So again, now doing another ratio comparison just to drill it in. So setting up a ratio like this allows us to solve for how much H2 we'd actually need to completely use up the N2. So solving like this, we'll get. So now with this ratio, the actual amount of H2 that we'd need to use is 1.338, and so we do not have that much, right? So we only have 0.681, and so we would need almost twice as much to use up all the nitrogen. So this means, once again, that H2 is your limiting reagent. We don't have enough to use up the N2, and for N2, that's our excess because we're not even going to use all 0.446 moles. So we can actually find out how much we're going to use by doing this ratio with hydrogen. So if we were going to completely use up our 0.681 moles of H2, let's solve for how many moles of N2 we'd need. And we end up with 0.227 moles of N2 we'd need. And we completely have this, right? Because we actually have 0.446 and we only need to use 0.227 moles. So that's another reason why N2 is the excess. We'd only would need 0.227 to completely react with the hydrogen, but we actually have 0.446. All right, hope this video helped clarify limiting reagent problems for you, and happy studying.
Hey, I hope you liked that video. Please feel free to like, comment, or subscribe. And if you go to my website, I have a ton of free practice problems you can check out. And if you need even more help, you can hire me for one-on-one private tutoring sessions that are online. All right, thanks. That's it. Happy studying.